Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I am a Kashmiri from the Azad part of the state. I feel the pain of my state more than anybody. We have a strong point to project our case in front of international community, morality. We are at high moral grounds to pursue our case to international community at global level, at Human Rights Commission, at the OIC. We often say that that international community is not sensitive about Kashmir issue. It is. It knows the fact, understands its sensitivity, but is silent and reluctant. Major powers share their economic interest with India. The seemingly civilized world would not lie to my India. Bill Clinton said that the most dangerous place on the earth is Kashmir. The world needs to solve Kashmir issue owing to the nuclear flashpoint. Despite the passage of almost 7 decades, people of the former princely state of Jammu and Kashmir are waiting for their basic human rights. Cradled in the majestic mountains of the Himalayas, Kashmir is the most beautiful place on earth. But unfortunately, the history is replete with plundering and looting the beauty of Kashmir. It has always been kept up its hidden treasures and natural resources by its invaders. These enemies not only plundered Kashmir, but they also treated innocent Kashmiris unjustly, inhumanly, barbarically. Kashmiris fought against this brutality for a long time. The deployment of over 800,000 Indian troops in the Indian-occupied Kashmir is a clear violation of international law and UN resolutions. India repeatedly claims Kashmir as an integral part of it. That's totally wrong. Kashmir is not an integral part of India and it's never been an integral part of it. The state of Jammu and Kashmir is a disputed territory between India and Pakistan. It's more a part of Pakistan than it can ever be with India with all her reluctance and extravagance of words. The people of Kashmir are the part of people of Pakistan in blood, in flesh, in life, kit and kin of heart, in history, in geography, in culture, in every way and every form. We should not abandon up. We are not aggressors, we are the victims of aggression. The Indian security forces deployed in Indian-held Kashmir have committed massive human rights violations. In fact, the dispute about the state of Jammu and Kashmir is not an issue of a piece of land, but is an issue of the basic human rights for Kashmiri people. It's a humanitarian issue as there are hundreds and thousands of killings of people and tens of thousands of gang rapes in the Indian-held Kashmir in the hands of Indian security forces. The so-called human rights champions are silent of a mess of human rights violations. Mr. President, I am in a deep shock. I am in a deep shock to watch videos and news coming from Indian-occupied Kashmir. My sisters, brothers and elders are being killed, murdered and humiliated by Indian Army. An international community is silent. Dozens of unarmed protesters have been massacred, beheaded and butchered. Thousands wounded, including hundreds of people blinded by the use of pellet gun in recent months. The number of half-breeders is continuously increasing. Many have fallen to prey to the psychological disorders, including depression, phobia, emotional instability and post-traumatic disorders. International community is still silent. Mr. President, I am in a deep shock that why the blind, deaf and dumb United Nations is unable to see unlawful bloodshed in Kashmir. I wonder, humans are only those who live in London, Paris and New York. I wonder, only those people have human rights who are living in London, Paris and New York. I wonder, it's only the women who live in America and England who are mothers. Is not a Kashmiri a human? Is not a Kashmiri woman a mother? Are Kashmiri children of a lesser god? Do Kashmiris not have rights called human rights? The history of mankind in Indian-occupied Kashmir is nothing but a pathetic story of perpetual sorrows, a woeful panorama of misery and pain, a panic account of horror and terror, torture, rape, plunder and custodial disappearances have become common. Violence erupts predictably in Kashmir. The death of martyr Burhan Muzaffarwani is a grisly reminder of the brutality that Kashmiris face as a result of their dream of freedom. Their bruises, their injuries and their impaired bodies are a slap on the face of international community. No matter what happens, the people of Indian-occupied Kashmir, young men and women are ready to give their blood for the liberation of Kashmir. Ladies and gentlemen, European Union has the power and moral ability to persuade both Pakistan and India to successfully resolve Kashmir conflict. Because Britain did mediate it between India and Pakistan and successfully resolved Rana of Kutch dispute. If it can do that, it can do this. Ladies and gentlemen, now let me deconstruct the reasons for weak global response. It's because realpolitik, profits and strategic alliances matter. That's why some of the nations, some who are the permanent members of Security Council, they have declared to align themselves with India. The international community openly admits it's standing with India because the vast population conforms its dynamic market. On the question of human rights standards, human rights treaties and conventions drafted by international community. That international community has evolved over centuries. It's custodian of what? It puts all the mechanisms to implement them. International community openly admits, yes, it has to face the problem of double standards in so-called developed nations. Lack of response and sense of responsibility from United Nations is one of the major contributing factors that has hampered the peaceful resolution of Kashmir conflict. It's UN Security Council's responsibility to implement its own resolutions. International community and global organizations need to convince India to stop human rights violations in Indian-occupied Kashmir, to give Kashmiris their right of self-determination. The question arises of the consciousness of the international community. The India must realize it cannot keep Kashmir as hostage anymore. We not only slogan and demand Azadi, but we also define it. Azadi ka matlab kya? La ilaha illallah. And we relate it to Pakistan. Pakistan ka matlab kya? La ilaha illallah. The people of Indian occupied Kashmir are signaling their absolute solidarity with the people of Pakistan in the state of Pakistan. I want to leave this impression that this ignorant and cold behavior of international community would stay no longer. And I can see the time is not far when people of Kashmir will celebrate freedom, inshallah.